I want to answer two questions from the text today, and in the hope that we're going to avoid pitfalls that that early church fell into. Two questions. One question is, what is the church? Second, who is the church for? And so we realize the church is made up of individuals, but we're not called to live in individualism and individualistic lifestyle. We're called to experience community. And there's even a better word, and the word community, when we use that English word, it really doesn't capture the full flavor of what I'm conveying. It's a Latin word, communitas. It's a gathering of people that said, the reason why we gather is because there's a bigger purpose than being by ourselves. And so we're called to be a community of people, and we're serving a bigger purpose than if we were just living by ourselves. And even that bigger purpose, at times, it takes risk. And we're willing to allow ourselves to be inconvenienced and to experience discomfort for the sake of the bigger purpose. The church is the expression of Jesus on the earth. And we're called to make adjustments in our lives and lifestyle. So when we come together, when people look at us, they say, wow, there's something different about those people. I want to hire them. I love when they work for me because their ethic is impeccable. I love when they provide service for me because they never shortchange me. In fact, they always go over the top. It's as if they're working for someone that's invisible, but they follow his direction. I love the ethic and the behavior and the morals of those people who call themselves Christ followers. That's what we want to see and hear about us. So let's deal with some rough questions. God had a dream going on here in Jerusalem. And when you notice that there was this spat, this difficulty that arose in the early church, this is the church of Jerusalem, the first church that was ever established. Two factions that I'll describe in a moment, Grecians and Hebraic. Both had and were Jewish in ethnicity and origin. Both groupings met Christ, but yet they couldn't get along with one another. And this difficulty of learning how to live as communitas, or in community with each other, it was marring the image and the impression of outsiders when they looked in at the church. And so I want you to realize that this particular tiff, this difficulty, the relational angst that was going on, it had the ability to interrupt and disrupt God's dream for Jerusalem. God had a dream for that city, and he put those people, he called them out of darkness and said, I'm changing you through this Christ transformation, this Christ event. You've been sinners, but now you're believers in the Lord Jesus. You no longer want to live immorally or spiritually bankrupt lives. You want to live with me ordering your steps, but my dream is being impinged based on how you treat each other. I want you to understand that the same way God had a dream for Jerusalem, God also has a dream for New Jersey, and he put us here as a local expression of his heart and his love, because he has a dream. And there's a dream going on here at Christ Church, and we must not lose sight of that. And our dream is captured in one single word called impact. Say that word with me, please. Impact. And each letter stands for a major facet of that dream. The I stands for integrate. The M stands for music. The P stands for prepare. The A represents academic. The C represents community. And the T stands for training. And so we're a church that aspired to be racially and ethnically and culturally integrated. Hence we sing songs like Te Amo, because there are people among us that English is not their primary language, and we want them to know they're welcome here. The music is something that we've emphasized, not because we just love hearing music, but we want music that has the beat in the heart of God, where we can say we get in touch with God in our worship and our expression of the arts. The P represents preparation. And so we're not saying to our children, our teens, that tomorrow is your day. No. We're saying today is your day. Hence, we bring visibility to the teens through and the children through prepare. And the A represents academics. We're a very strong, academic-oriented church. That's why there's always a lot of building up, such as the learning center and other ways that one grows academically. The C represents community. Last year alone, we invested through our two campuses, 7 weekend services. We volunteered collectively over 25,000 man hours in some 20 to 30 organizations within this region. I want you to realize we're concerned about the community and helping to influence and be salt and light. We can't be salt and light just staying within the four walls of the church. And the T represents training. We're a strong training church. This last week, we finished one of the semesters of the School of Prayer. And when we launched the School of Prayer, it became a national voice and 11 different sites across the nation. Just over the past month, we've trained over several thousand people in the fundamentals of prayer, birth out of our house. Why? Because we are a church that aspire to train, impact, is the dream that God put in our hearts, and we're still living out that dream today, some 27 years later. And I want to invite you to come and join the dream. Roll up your sleeves and let's experience communitas, where the deepest thing in you connects with the deepest thing in me, and we join our hearts together and say, we're willing to live lives that at times we're inconvenienced and we experience discomfort for the greater thing of making sure our voice represents the voice of God in our generation. Anybody here want to be a part of the dream that God has for this generation, this time, this hour? And so that's what it's all about.